The best way to understand the objective of the MAPIS project is to explain why the east side of cities is always the poorest. It was true in Victorian England, but it is also true in Paris or in New York or in other places. We tend to observe always that the east side of city is poorer than the west side of city. And the explanation is quite simple. It was due to pollution in the past and prevailing winds that tend to go from the west to the east in most of our latitudes.
Pillars of progress, machines to make machines, production to expand production.
And so in most of these cities, you had these chimneys at the center of the city, the pollution blowing towards the east side, rich people moving towards the west side. And even when pollution disappeared, in the 60s, for instance, in the case of England and Wales, this original distribution remained through the persistence of segregation. The way to derive this result is to keep track of the evolution of the city over time, manage to locate pollution sources, to locate individuals as well, and relate this pollution exposure to residential segregation. One question is, how do you manage to reconstruct the city at the time and the evolution of this city? And there is a dormant source of information that has so far not been exploited, which are historical maps. So in the 19th century, Victorian mappers, they were extremely fastidious, and they were going from cities to cities, drawing maps very precisely with trees, industrial chimneys, indicating factories, indicating pub houses. The only problem is that this information, which looks like Google Map in the past, is not digitized. It's an information that is scanned. So for researchers, it looks like an image, but none of the objects on the map are proper objects. And so the goal of MAPIS is to digitize this object, transform these maps into a Google Map in the past, at different periods in time, in 1880, 1900, 1920, 1940, and follow the evolution of cities over time. Why are we interested in the evolution of cities over time? It's because the mechanisms that I've highlighted earlier about neighborhood segregation is just part of the story. So during this period, there is vast migration from rural areas the rural hinterlands to the cities, with migrants making the city grow towards certain directions. There is a process through which the factories decided to relocate in different parts of the cities, exacerbating somehow this neighborhood segregation. There are also aspects of public amenities and schools and churches and hospitals moving in the city. And in order to understand this very long-run development of the city, we need to keep track of this. There are two reasons why MAPIS is an important piece of research. The first is that it makes available incredible data. The second reason is it shows how current decisions and how current political reforms that may affect the distribution of economic activity in cities may have very long-run consequences on the development of these cities. It is important because now we are thinking about not commuting, about driving these amenities outside of cities. All those reforms having not only an impact in the short run, but more importantly, a very long run impact. This is why MAPIS is interesting not only to economists, historians, and so forth, but also to current policymakers.